the wonderful feeling, the realization of these 3 days. We have so many people here from 18 African countries all together, more than 140 registered participants. We have receptions in the evening, we have on the 30 an excursion to the Vienna's water, drinking water wells. So we have different talks and presentations, as it was said before, from projects in our program. Yeah, it feels like, you know, realizing a thing that you have prepared for a long time.
You know, there's a saying in Africa which says, people who don't travel think their mother is the best cook. So it gives you that open-mindedness and globalization, and therefore you start seeing a local solution from a global perspective. So, and that's why you find a lot of students really foresee Austria as one of those partners who will give them that opportunity and also will give them a chance to express themselves. Africa-UniNet has created a very big network among the member institutes, particularly through the Africa-UniNet funded projects, where many members have actually created new networks and new knowledge for both African and Austrian universities.
Well, as OeAD, we support the connection and collaboration between universities and research institutions between Austria and African countries. And on the one hand, we organize events, but also we provide funding for collaboration. A network like Africa-UniNet can only be the basis. We have a little bit of funding for smaller projects, but the aim really is that we also look into funding from, for example, the European side, Erasmus Plus projects, or maybe even bigger projects in the framework of Horizon Europe.
We can learn a lot from African culture and also African partners, because in principle lots of things are similar like in Austria. People would like to have a secure life, they would like to have some financial security, and they want to have their family protected. My personal idea of the Africa-UniNet would be that it has an impact in the countries, so that we see in the long run some improvements according to the needs of the African partners.
The African Academy of Sciences is the voice of science in Africa. And that's why the African Union identified the Academy as, you know, the one to bring together all scientists. But not only the natural sciences, it's also with the human sciences. So we want to see how we can bring science, policy, and society together. You know, the African continent is one of the only continent with a vision for 50 years through the African We Want, Agenda 2063. And some of the agenda is we want to grow, you know, scientific excellence on the continent. That's one. Food security is another one. Health is another one. Climate change, you know, mitigation, but more of adaptation to climate change. Because, for example, we don't contribute much to the carbon depletion in the world, but we suffer most from that. So how do we create the opportunity to adapt to that? But then also coming together, working together as Africans, sharing information, knowledge together, so that, you know, all the African countries will be able to leapfrog. So this is the Africa we want.
It's also about expanding our reach as a university, collaborations. We have a lot of common areas we need to address: food security, agriculture, climate change, education, among other that a lot of the collaborative projects focus on. It's all about perspective, context, local environment, national environment, diverse views and approaches. So it's to enrich, you know, because we're not going to solve problems on our own, so we all have to work together.
what I understand by decolonization of African mind is, without denying the historical colonization and slavery, without denying the barbarity of racism, slavery and colonization, we have to free ourselves for this perpetuation of the legacies of colonization. Decolonizing the mind means we take responsibility for our shortcomings, for our inadequacies today, for political conflicts, for economic poverty, and for all kinds of migrations. That means people leaving their countries, going to the West, as if the West is always the solution for everything. African researchers have the responsibility and the duty to take, to raise the awareness of Africans, to say that there is, that there lies this problem. That means that the problem of lack of understanding the responsibility of Africans themselves and for current situations, without denying the historical facts. That is the task of African researchers within the context of Africa-UniNet.
Joining the network for us was a strategic move, because this was the first time ever we would be dealing or cooperating with universities from Austria. And at the same time, to us, it is also a national strategy, because our relationships have been are spanning centuries. More than two centuries ago, we started our historical relations. They're continuing, and they are gaining premium. So, rooting this, I think, into research, rooting this into academia, rooting this into collaborations between intellectuals, researchers, professors, I think will make it more fruitful, but also more meaningful, because of the impact that science has on the livelihoods of people.
When we joined Africa-UniNet, one of the main objectives was, how do we advance the technology knowledge that we have to impact the society, as we also focus on the SDGs. And as a member of Africa-UniNet, I think one, apart from collaborative research, we can also look at exchange of ideas from the north, south, 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 and even north-north. So as a university, we expect to have more collaborators, more networks, so that we can exchange knowledge for the capacity building of the society. I have a very long history with Austria. One, I was a student here for my PhD and also for my postdoc. A number of colleagues at the technical university, they are former students of BOKU and other universities in Austria. Austria has interest for the growth of universities and research centers in Africa. And also Africa wants to tap the knowledge from Austria. Of course, most of the universities in Austria are from 19th centuries, while in universities in Kenya, some are very young. So we can draw the wild experience that you have to grow our institutions. And I think there's a lot of research that can be done both by the two partners from Austria and from Africa.
My first suggestion was, we have to be a member and we have to deal much more with Africa. For me as a demographer, this number is so impressive. At the end of that century, 40% of the world population will live in Africa. And it's not responsible to neglect this large, diverse and interesting continent. Therefore, we have to start and we have to support this network. It's good that, let's say, excellent institutes in Austria are cooperating with excellent institutes in Africa. We have to look that is a cooperation on equal height.
Thematic areas are chosen for cooperation activities which affect the African partner, which are local problems, which are things where scientific solutions can provide an improvement of daily life of many people And at the same time, these local problems are very often connected to global problems and global challenges. And in this context, I think the profit is on both sides.
I would say that our partnership with Austrian universities is very important because there are no grudges. There is no belligerence in our relationships. It's a smooth, historical, friendly relationship. And we can look at one another as equals. And this is very important in research. This is very important for science.